the Legal Eagle. My guest this week is someone who's been the president of the Gujarat High Court Bar Association for 14 consecutive terms. He's a seasoned advocate and also a politician. We welcome on the show Mr. Yatin Oza. Mr. Oza, as I welcome you, thank you for being here. I want to begin by asking you of the early years, the young years. Your father was one of the most known Gujarat advocates, but I also know you wanted to join the army. You'd also be chosen as a lieutenant at the age of 21. What prompted you to make the switch? Tell us a little bit about those early years.
No, my passion was at that point of time to join Indian Army and serve the nation. But somehow my second passion was legal profession. I still feel that I should have joined Indian Army. But anyway, circumstances then, I gave a thought, and possibly, to be very honest, won't be able to undergo such rigorous training and very hard life. In a most cowardice manner, I chose to come back to legal profession. I will be very candid with you. And legal profession, as I said, was my second choice. And I got a good break since the beginning. And I visualized that this is the field where I will be able to successful. I will be much successful as I have thought of. And that's how I came to the profession, legal profession.
But coming back to those early years, I want to know about the chambers that you joined. What were the early years like? What were the first practices like? How soon before you got your first briefs? And how much influence did your father himself have on you?
Look, at the outset, let me tell you, the day I got my sanad, that is a license to practice, my father told me that from today, your practice has to be independent. You are not going to be dependent on me. You will have a separate office, which of course, that part he had helped me to buy. And your clerk would be separate, your litigation would be separate. You will not engage me in one matter as a senior counsel, and I will not refer any client your name to assist me. That's how I had started. But I must say that I earned and gained a lot of experience during my student days with Mr. P.B. Mazmudar's office, who later on came to become a judge of the Gujarat High Court and then Bombay High Court. Those 3 years were the turning point of my life joining while I was in his chamber.
Mr. Oza, also I want to know, what were the impactful cases that you have been a part of that, like you said, were a turning point for you, that you were influenced with, some that you saw when you were growing up and some that you were a part of in your mid-30s?
That's right. First, coming to my own experience, I appeared in a matter where a senior superintendent of police in Gujarat, in those days where nomenclature was district superintendent of police, was suspended in a very controversial case. That was almost 6 or 7 months of my practice. And a lawyer from Baroda had referred that case, late Mr. Ramani. And I was very successful in getting his suspension set aside and to get him reinstated. That case, in maybe 83, I started in July 82. In 83, February, I got that order, or rather court passed that order in favor of my client. That gave me a big boost. And thereafter, possibly, I was, for quite a good number of years, I represented 90% of the cases of the police department that came to the High Court not for the government, but for the employees, officers, and constabulary to highest rank officer. And surprisingly, when after 5 years of practice, I was successful in getting my bungalow out of my own earnings, people said that you must give the name of this bungalow as Police Krupa. Then came another case of a triple murder. That was not a regular appeal, but was a bail petition. That is, I'm talking of 84 beginning, wherein I got the bail in a case of triple murder for 14 people. That gave me again a good chance to appear in number of criminal matters with which I was, to be honest, not that familiar with. But in those good old days, not that I disrespect today, judges used to build the lawyers. They used to take very keen interest. If I am today where I am, most of the credit goes to Honorable Justice M.P. Thakkar, late MP Justice M.P. Thakkar, who had no connection with me. But on the fifth day of my practice, when he saw me arguing, he took so keen interest in building my career that I find short of words how to tender my or how to express myself in obligation for that great judge. There are many in Gujarat High Court who can be termed as product of so-and-so judge, product of so-and-so judge, product of so-and-so judge. I can say that I am product of Justice M.P. Thakkar, without whom I would not have reached half than what I am today.
Mr. Oza, you've also been very clearly one of the leaders when it comes to the Gujarat High Court Bar Association. You've been chosen 16 times, 14 consecutive times. What is the impact that you have, that you keep winning these elections and taking care of lawyers who continue joining the profession, and each time you continue to be chosen to lead them?
Before I was elected as a president for the first time in 1994, at the age of 34, I held the position of vice president for 6 terms and secretary general for 1 term. And I may correct you, it's not 14 consecutive terms. I have been elected 17th time, and this is my 18th year as a president of the bar. 17 elections I have contested, and barring one, I have succeeded in all elections. And more or less, it's because of the love that my seniors have for me, respect that the junior advocates have for me, and most importantly, I have been successful in fulfilling the expectations and dreams of the junior advocates. I always stand with them like a rock. Whenever they are faced with a rough weather, whether inside the courtroom or outside the court, I am always there to help them. And I have never shirked from my duty to see that junior is put to any difficulties, or I have tried rather to see that least difficulties juniors are faced with. And as late Mr. Sharad Vakil, a stalwart of one time, used to say that Mr. Oza has a constituency, as politicians have, and that constituency is of junior advocates. I am so happy that even lady advocates, by one voice, either see in me a face of a brother or face of a father. And that is how the confidence that they have in me, that here is a person who will stand with us like a father, here is a person who will stand with us like a brother. That's how there's an en bloc voting of lady advocates in my favor. So also junior advocates. Because whenever you see, judges have 100 matters, 150 matters, sometimes they also lose their cool, not intentionally, but by force, or whether because of the reason that they are tired, or because of the reason that they are not able to withstand the pressure of work, because Gujarat has always, always found itself in great deficit of judges, I stand up I request the judge, I apologize on behalf of the advocate, and I see that things are set right. I also get up sometimes when juniors are not able to express and court is not able to properly follow because that is a complete lack of expression. Then I get up and say that this is what he wants to convey, this is what his case is, and that's how sometimes they have walked out with favorable orders. And that's one of the reasons that they have chosen to elect me 17 times as the president of the bar.
That's marvelous. I stand corrected. And Mr. Oza, you mentioned the word constituency, so I wanted to speak about the politician that is also Mr. Oza. You, in your mid-30s, in 1995, you first won the MLA elections from Sabarmati. In 1998, once again. In 2001, you joined the Congress. In 2012 elections, you returned to the BJP, and now you are with the Aam Aadmi Party. What is your political ideology? And no, where is the politician, Mr. Oza, fitting with the... You were last with the Aam Aadmi Party. Where is the politician, Mr. Oza, is what I wanted to understand.
I must tell you one thing. I am a hopeless failure in politics. And therefore, I am completely out of politics now. You are right, in 1995, I got elected. In 1998, I got elected. And what people say in Gujarat is that since I resigned, and my constituency was one of the seat of Vidhan Sabha of Gandhinagar Lok Sabha seat, which was represented by Advani ji. And since that seat was lost by BJP, that Honorable the Prime Minister came as a Chief Minister of Gujarat. And the then incumbent had to vacate the seat in favor of the present Honorable Prime Minister. I joined BJP again in 2007, and I was not the official spokesperson of BJP, but I was official spokesperson of Mr. Modi, and that I continued till 2014. And then possibly I left the politics, I don't know why I came back, for a very brief period. Otherwise, that was the happiest decision I had made in my life, that after 2014, for 4 years, having defended Mr. Modi on personal terms, not BJP also, of course, it was enough. But anyway, as I said, I am absolutely failure as a politician, and I don't mind openly saying that it was none else than me myself to be blamed for the same.
Mr. Oza, I also want to ask you, you spoke about young lawyers. We've been in a situation across India where we've seen the hybrid system, the virtual system and the physical system work together. How do you think the way forward would be? A lot of times we are seeing in the Supreme Court that they say that a hybrid system could be seen as a silver lining. According to you, keeping in mind everything that you've been seeing across India, where do you think does the virtual courts, the e-courts, how good a future possibility is it for India?
Look, I personally believe that the society in which we live, the socio-economic structure of the country, to me, there is no substitution to physical courts. This is my personal view. I have seen lawyers running a lorry selling fruits. On 31st of May, it was my wedding anniversary, and I ordered food. The person who came to deliver the food at my house was none else than a lawyer having 7 years of standing. My WhatsApp messages are full with the difficulties being faced by lawyers, and more particularly junior lawyers. The system has ruined them. But anyway, that was a compulsion then. I am still at a total loss, that when government permitted 60,000 spectators to the stadium, let me tell you, government is the custodial aegis of law and order, health, and all other concern is a matter within the sole domain of the government. State Election Commission in Gujarat held elections involving almost 4.5 crores of people. I am sure Election Commission, before holding the elections or before taking the decision to hold the elections, must have consulted, starting from the top cabinet, chief secretary, additional chief secretaries of several departments, all district collectors, all police heads, all heads of the fire department, all civil surgeons, all district development officers, so on and so forth. That, and most importantly, the team of doctors, termed as a body of expert doctors, constituted by the state government. And if this thing went on smoothly, I don't think that there is any justification still to continue with either virtual hearing or hybrid system. But Yati Roza is one thing, and President of Gujarat High Court Advocates Association is another thing. If my 20, out of 2400 members, 2000 members want the court to physically open, and as I said, that if elections can take place, if victory processions can go on, if election public meetings can go on, candidates go on the round for meeting the electorate, not less than 400-500 in number, I don't think there exists any good reason, in my humble opinion, to still continue with shutting down the court. And that is what exactly Mr. Vikas Singh, newly elected president of SCBA, has also written a letter to Honorable the Chief Justice of India. My letter is a week prior to that.
In fact,
wherein with folded hands, I have with folded hands requested the Honorable the Chief Justice of Gujarat High Court and his honorable companion judges that now please open the court for physical hearing.
My last question that I wanted to then ask you, what do you do in your private time? What are the passions? What do you like doing other than spending time with people of the Gujarat High Court Bar Association and the members? What are your personal passions?
My personal passion is to read novels. That's my passion to my heart. People say that I read extra books so much that I hardly find time to read my case papers. That's on a lighter side. Secondly, I like to watch cricket matches, and these are the days where cricket fever is going on around Ahmedabad. But unfortunately, my daughters, they don't permit me to go to the stadium and watch the match. So I watch the matches, all, not only India playing, but whenever I get a free time, I keep on watching cricket. Very rarely I find a free time, but whenever little time that I have, and these days I have developed a new passion or a hobby, that from 4 in the evening to 7:30 in the evening, I devote the time to junior advocates, that if they have any difficulties, I sit with them and I try to guide them. These 3.5 hours are reserved for junior advocates who find difficult to argue a matter, or who finds difficult to draft a matter, or who finds difficult in any manner to deal with their matter, even dealing with the clients. These 3.5 hours I devote to them. Juniors and lady advocates, I have already said. The senior members of the bar also, they shower utmost love to me. And I am the one who can proudly say that on every occasion where the bar felt that independence of judiciary is attacked, I have led from the front. I have never let the judiciary down by any attempts of executive. And that's where I am proud, and I will live proudly till the last breath.
Absolutely. Thank you, sir, for being with us on The Legal Eagle, for giving us this advice. And like I said, I started off by saying 14, but now I realize in the end why you've been chosen 17 times as being the president of the Gujarat High Court Bar Association. Thank you for being a part of The Legal Eagle this week. See you next week, viewers.
Thank you.